A very good evening to all the dignitaries present on the dais and all my fellow companions. I, Soumya Jain, student manager of Sri Balaji Society, feels privileged to introduce you all the versatile personality, Mr. Dinesh Bhojwani. Sir did his graduation in BCom from Devi Ahilya Vishwavidyalaya. And then he completed his MBA from Human Resource Management. Sir has worked with ICICI Lombard Limited as Regional Manager HR. And then he served Reliance Retail Limited as AGM HR. Later, sir worked with Tata Life Insurance Limited. And then he appointed as Vice President HR at IndusLand Bank. Sir is presently working as Head Distributor HR at Star Union Dai Ichi Life Insurance Company Limited. And now I call upon Dinesh Bhojwani, sir, to share his knowledge and experience with us. Sir, the dais is all yours.
Okay, so the question here is this a different time? You know, is it different from what it was just about 2 years back? Is it different from, you know, what it will be in the future? So, look at this. There is a whole lot of revolution that is taking place in the world. Okay, which comprises of technology. One of the important pillars of this revolution that is happening in the world is technology, and therefore automation. Another one is weaponry. You know, we are all privy to what is happening in North Korea, and we are, you know, what's happening between the rocket men and in the rest of the world. Yeah, that's how. And the third one is human rights, where all of us are involved, where all of us are, you know, talking about our own freedom, our own privacy, our own professions. Yeah. Now, the idea of, you know, putting these three things is, please understand that times are ever changing. They have never stopped for us, and they will never stop for us in future as well. Therefore, it is important for us to be ready for the future. It is important for us to be ready for, you know, to embrace change continuously. Now, this is enough of lecture, and this is enough of talk that you must have been privy to, you must have heard, and, you know, blah, blah, blah. But the idea is to set this context more, to develop this plinth and to reaffirm, you know, amongst us today that we are actually moving into that direction. We are actually preparing for the future. Yeah. So that's mostly. So my talk is going to be all around, you know, automation and human rights and what is our role, how will machinery or artificial intelligence or machine intelligence will coexist in the future. Okay. So the world that we live in today, how many of us are aware of what VUCA is, VUCA world? Okay, great. Okay. So the VUCA world, the world is volatile. Now, since most of you are aware, 90% of you guys are aware, you are aware of the definitions as well. The uncertainty of times. Are you aware that, you know, this was a term coined by the US military for, you know, they for Afghanistan and Iraq. I mean, they said that the world is VUCA world in Afghanistan and Iraq. And that's from there the corporate world has actually taken over this jargon, and we are so famous for taking over. It's fashionable to use these terms, you see. Yeah. Now, uncertain times. Then you have complex times. Yeah. People say world is complex, but human beings, we make it a little more complicated. Yeah, that's, and then the whole world is confusing, which is, the world is ambiguous. You know, little thing there, you know, which talks about, I know that it is not legible from there. It is by the founder of, you know, it is a comment on the millennials. It is the comment on the ever-changing world. Okay, the world is changing in this way. Why people call it VUCA world? Why the corporates are calling VUCA world? Because the world is changing this way. What is written there is that the most of the jobs are being now taken away by technology. Is that true? How many of you believe that the jobs are being taken away by technology, artificial intelligence? Do you believe that? Sorry? Well, thankfully, there are some people who don't believe in that. Because you see, what we will have to understand is technology has always existed in some form. Technology will continue to exist, but coexist with human beings. The careers will change. The idea of jobs or the idea of work will change. Yeah. Now, what you see here is that McDonald's has done away with some jobs, you know, somewhere in the equity space, you know, Goldman Sachs, they have changed their equity traders, you know, and they have made some job redundants. But that's news, and you will continue to hear this in the VUCA world. But the VUCA world, the positive side of VUCA world would be that there will be enough and more opportunities also available for all of us here and people outside. I don't know how many of you got this, you have been, you know, busy since morning. There is a news article today in the Hindu, the newspaper, the Hindu. It says by 2022, artificial intelligence will create about 2.3 billion or some jobs, you know. Now, these jobs are not going to be, you know, the jobs that we do today, but these jobs are going to be different jobs. You know, as we move along, as we move on with some slides, I will also try to unfold certain work areas that I feel or I think are going to be important for all of us in the future or the jobs of the future. This is the country. The HR guys, you know, like me and some of you, we are grappling with diversity. We understand that two jargons, those are being used, are diversity and inclusiveness. Yeah. Now, India is a diverse country. It is many countries within the same country. I have put some statistics, maybe may not be legible from there, but it reads that there are four main regions, there are 3,000 castes and 4,635 identifiable communities, there are 22 languages, and there are so many 1,500 plus mother tongues, and then there are many scripts. Now, what does that mean? That means a lot of diversity. That means the corporate world is also embracing a lot of diversity. What I have shown here is, since I come from, you know, I work for SUD Life Star Union Dai Ichi. See, we also have, so it is not a promotion of the company, but at the same time, I am trying to build the context here. We have 92 offices across India, and we hire the same diverse workforce. Yeah, is the limited point that I am trying to make here. Now, this diverse workforce brings in sort of challenges. These diverse workforce, you know, brings in different kind of thought process, different philosophies that they follow. Yeah, it becomes important for the corporates to embrace them while creating jobs for them, while creating work for them. This is now the theme also had, you know, 21st century jobs, 21st century work in 21st century. You see, the workforce is going to be like this. Now, what you see here in this picture, they are all on cloud. Cloud, we associate cloud, of course, with rains, but apart from that, we also associate it with technology. Yeah, they are all on working on cloud from different places. People have been speaking about global world and blah, blah, blah. Now, this is what the global world is about. You see their dressings, you see their appearance. This is going to be the organization of 21st century. Yeah, this is going to be the workforce of the 21st century. You see diverse people, diversity here. What we have studied, and there is enough and more data on this, that there are millennials, you know, they are deserving a better place. Now, what you see, some statistics here once again, 33% of the people, you know, are finding it difficult to manage work, family and all of that. And I think you guys are also being trained for, you know, not to have those difficulties in future. You have 75% people who want different kind of work. They have different abilities to perform. They are not like, you know, they are not like us who have spent about 15, 20 years and they have accustomed or they have, you know, kind of fixated to a particular style of working. But these people are more demanding. You guys are more demanding. You are demanding the world differently. Yeah, that's what the statistics here is. I also would like to, you know, speak a little bit about two things, you know, two little examples that I've seen from, you know, I've also heard about this. How is the workplace changing? How is the work changing? How is the job changing? You know, some of you said artificial intelligence or the machine intelligence are taking away jobs from us. Now, partly it is true. I'll tell you how it is true. There is this small story. There is a restaurant called Kura Sushi. You know, sushi, it's a Japanese food. Yeah, some. Now, Kura Sushi is a restaurant which runs about 262 restaurants in whole of Japan. Yeah. Now what they have done is, what artificial or machine intelligence has done it for them, or the mechanization has done it for them, is that that sushi comes to your table, on your table, without any, really very, without any human intervention. Now what does that mean? That means that there is one person who is managing the restaurant, but your food is practically untouched. Yeah, you place your order using your fingertips on a panel. Okay, your order reaches the kitchen with the help of the robots, you know, they prepare your sushi. The sushi comes to you through some mechanism which is not human beings. The machinery is not human beings. It comes to your table, you will put the dishes in a particular designated corner and the dishes will go for recycling. Now there is practically no human touch there. Yeah. Now these are those areas where we, all of us, need to be future ready. Now we may say that the jobs are being taken away, you know, by machines. But then how do we survive? Human beings are more agile. So how do we survive in the current world and in the VUCA world and in the future? Collectively, we will have to discover. We will have to find out. Once again, I have some statistics that I would like to share with you. How are the jobs changing? How are we being aided more and more by the machinery rather than jobs being taken away by the machinery? Yeah, I'm sure you must be looking into various TED Talks, you're YouTubers. I mean, you guys are YouTubers. There are about 2 million people in the world, 2 billion people in the world who use Facebook. About 1.5 billion people in the world who are using YouTubes. So the top three things, you know, that is the kind of affection, or that is the kind of forced choice for some of us, but that's the kind of natural choice or the automatic choice that we are having in the world today. You know, you cannot disdain technology, you cannot move away, go away from the technology, one will have to exist with the technology. That's what is about the, you know, preparation for the future. Similarly, there is an example that comes to my mind. You know, US is fond of playing baseball. All of us know, it's like, you know, and we know the sport a little bit. Now, there was this baseball match, you know, after the match, the entire commentary of the match, you know, was reproduced in a matter of few minutes. Okay. Now look at this. It was a beautiful story. People thought it is done by humans, or it is done by some journalist or some author or somebody who writes, who is a sports journalist. What happened was, this was actually done by a robot or a computer. Now look at this. There is a match, a live match which goes on. There are machines watching. They are picking up relevant data. They are picking up patterns. They are picking up important moments from that particular match and reproducing the same stuff to you in form of theory, in form of an article within a few minutes of time. Now, is it not terrifying? It is terrifying for the first time when I read, personally speaking for me, because it is an intelligent job. I mean, till date, we have been writing essays. Till date, we've been taught to write English language. We've been taught to write Hindi or various other languages and beautify the language. Yeah, this has been the job of human beings. But then these jobs are being reproduced now by the machines. Now, therefore, we will have to reinvent ourselves. Okay? That's little bit there. These are some spaces, you know, of the workplace. How many of you have seen the movie Intern? My God, you have a pretty much informed, you know, crowd. Yeah, Intern. It's the Robert De Niro movie with Anne Hathaway. Do you see that the roles have been reversed in that movie? The roles are being reversed. How many of us agree with that? Now there is a millennial who is running the company. Yeah, good that you agreed. There is a 70-year-old intern, you know, who is going to the workplace. But did you see, the beauty of the movie is, it's a positive movie, by the way. You know, there is no villain there. There is all of them are protagonists. Now, the beauty about the movie is that 70-year-old guy has been accepted in the organization. For what? For the wisdom, for the experience that the person has built. Finally, the lady, you know, the actress there is trying to find out trying to find out a CEO who can mentor, or rather a mentor, you know, in form of a CEO. But here is the guy, the help comes for free, you know, as an intern. And the life, the entire thing gets sorted out for the lady and for the entire family and for the organization. You must have also watched in the movie and how the old and the new will coexist. From the same building, this gentleman who was the VP of some organization, they were making phone books. If some of you remember the movies, Robert De Niro was making phone books, the conventional phone books. And that was a factory which got converted into an office space. And the gentleman who retired from there, superannuated as a VP from there, comes back as an intern to the same place in a different role. Now the beauty is that the world is evolving. Yeah, world is evolving in a very little space of time. Yeah, which all of us need to be privy. We will have to accept, and we will have to. The world is not going to be same in the third semester and in the fourth semester, and as you embrace jobs and you take jobs. Yeah. Now these are some of the, you know, pictures from the modern workplace. That probably is Google. You know, the last one, the sixth one is Google, where they have a smorgasbord and a complete buffet of things. You also, another thing that I would like to comment on, you know, briefly, as far as job space is concerned, and one in the insurance context, because I work for an insurance organization, life insurance company, and one for, generally, do we understand radiology a little bit? That the test that we have, yeah, 90% plus jobs of the radiologists have been made redundant in the US, you know, by machinery, by artificial intelligence, because there is so much of big data, there is so much of data analytics, there is so much of decision making, which is being based on. And the reports are published in a span of nothing, no time. Therefore, and I happened to visit Japan the last, last month. What I saw there, and we have, Daiichi has 7 group companies, and we also have a company, you know, called Protective Life, which is a life insurance company in the US. You know, they also were represented. And when I asked, do you see a disruption because of technology and artificial intelligence and all of that? The answer was affirmative. They said, yes, it is making big waves, and it is also making some jobs redundant, but people are, you know, discovering themselves. Yeah, the human beings are more agile, they are more adaptive, they are changing themselves. Another thing that comes to my mind in the insurance space, there is something called underwriting. Are we students of insurance to some bit, some commerce? So there is science that is called underwriting in insurance space. Now, there is, even in India, you know, abroad, there are 90% plus things are straight through. They call it straight through process. That means the policies are untouched by human beings. Okay, so policies are sold. It moves from a digital screen to another digital screen, and it goes to the underwriters, and underwriting is also through the machinery, and the policy is delivered. Now that does not mean that we need to be, you know, what we should be worried or prepared for is the job or the landscape which is changing. The jobs, those are going to be available for us, and we will have to continuously evolve, you know, with times. That's how many of us, I see that you guys see a lot of movies and very good movies. Have you seen Elysium? Yeah? Elysium? Okay, another interesting movie. Have you seen Her? H-E-R. My God. Very good. Now, these are interesting movies. These are interesting movies where the human beings are actually exist with machinery, or rather machineries are making adjustments with human beings, and human beings are making adjustments. And it's all about, in Her, what you see, the protagonist who's in love with that operating system, yeah, is an author, is a writer, okay, and he's from a very well-to-do family with a very well-to-do educated background. Yeah, so that's how this is a picture from Elysium. This one, and there is a movie. This is so the technology is at your fingertips. The radio, the radiology, and some of the other jobs are being taken away. But then at the same time, artificial intelligence is also bringing in. So you will have to make technology a part of your life. Yeah, whether you work in HR, I come from HR. We see a lot of data. Now, the analogy that I draw between HR and business is, that businesses have started using technology long time back, or predictive analysis or analytics long time back. And therefore, the jobs that those are being created in this space are, they're called business intelligence. So the people who with some, you know, with some data background or with some mathematical background, they work on these data points and they help or aid companies take decisions. So the decision making is more predict, or they do, it is called predictive analysis. So some of you guys, you know, who have this kind of background will be well accepted by the corporates for this business intelligence. Similarly, in the HR space, the HR is also waking up, or they have already woken up to some extent, you know, where what is happening is HR has started working on matrices. Yeah, I'll take a simple example, attrition. You know, companies, because millennials keep leaving jobs and they keep moving for greener pastures, people go on for good. The organizations have started understanding attrition better with the data and the information that is available. Now, these are those areas where most of the jobs are, you know, getting available. Now, we never thought that the HR and technology or robotics will coexist. I'll just give you an example. You know, in Japan, in some of the organizations, HR operations, they've started to deploy chatbots and, you know, computers and artificial intelligence and robot, you know, in the developed, in the evolved world. Now, that does not mean that we will not have work. We will have work where you need counseling, you need to counsel employees, you need to engage with the employees more. That's where the human touch is involved, because we are more agile. We are, you know, in 1.5, you know, pounds of green in jelly here. We have, you know, we have more to do. We have more connect. We need that connect with the technology as well as, you know, human beings. Therefore, we will have to discover ourselves better. Some of the careers that I feel are going to be important in 21st century, and this is my perspective, and of course I've done some reading and some, you know, secondary research by picking up some stuff, you know, from Google as well. So some of the things that are required, you see, first of all, millennials are being associated with communication, media and digital. These are going to be the buzzwords of future and the current times as well. Yeah, so some of the jobs which are, you know, which are going to be available are bringing up, you know, artificial intelligence and robots for the scientists, computational philosophers, to ensure human aligned ethics and embedded, because there is so much of foul play also in technology. Yeah, I'll read out some stuff that, you know, on my way from Mumbai to Pune, I was making a note. So I'll just read out that stuff when I go back to the chit that I have. And robot personality designers, Siri is an important, have you had a conversation with Siri, the operating system? Do you find Siri intelligent? Yeah, they will respond back. I mean, you try abusing Siri. Yeah, and each and every data point that you share is being captured for research somewhere. And the software is continuously evolving. There is a term called singularity in artificial intelligence, which is where the machines, are we aware of singularity? There is singularity in space, there is singularity in artificial intelligence. What does that mean in artificial intelligence is that the machine will be capable of learning and repairing itself. Now that's terrifying. It's like human being. They will learn and the machine will repair. Repair in the sense not correct, but the machine will be intelligent enough and it will exist singularly, you know, in order to repair and correct the thought process. Yeah, the machine itself. There are, have you seen Frank and Robot? No? Watch that. Where the protagonist is educating the computer to, you know, he's making a robber out of the computer. Okay, sorry, not a computer, a robot. You must watch this. The movie is called Frank and Robot. Autonomous vehicles, we already know that Tesla is in the market and, you know, the autonomous vehicles are being tried. Yeah, the space which is left for us is arts, creativity and imagination. Now, imagination is not the cup of tea of, you know, machinery, for sure. What machinery can do is, what Watson can do, what Siri can do, what Cortana and what others can do, is understand patterns. Yeah, They will understand patterns and they will beat you in the game. But they will not be imaginative enough. You know, not in the near future. Where they will start thinking. Where the machine will start thinking. So that is the area which is left open for the imagination, you know. Then there are spaces in human resources. More and more we will need counselors. We will need counselors at workplace. We will need, you know, analytics to make decision making foolproof. To make decision making future ready. We definitely have international law, which is what we need. Yeah, because the world is becoming global. You have research, you have digital marketing, big data and content creation. Alternative energy. Okay. And so the mechanics, the engineers, the scientists, the plant managers, the sales and marketing professionals will only come from here. And then you have healthcare workers, you know, when the aging population. So you see, by 2018, there are 4 million jobs. 4 million jobs will be added, you know, by 2018 in this particular space. Yeah, where the aging populations in our own country, not so much, but outside will need help. There are not enough people, the health practitioners or the trained health practitioners who are available in the world. Now, these are some of the jobs that I think one can embrace, one can think of, one should look forward to. Yeah, and then there is customer-centric work, which is not going to go away. Now, I would try to, you know, I have a model that we, this is particularly that we use for, you know, in order to engage with the customers. Now, at every stage, now this is a little complex, you know, planetary type of a diagram. But what I want to make sure, you know, what I want to convey here is that there is a customer and anything which is to do with the customer jobs. The example that I was talking about, the US and US, you know, the machinery taking away the jobs. Now, the flip side of such thing is that the customer engagement or the customer connect is severed or is ends completely. Now, what happens there is, insurance is a business where we need to have a continuous connect with, you know, it is not a commodity that you buy and you go. You will have to subscribe to it and you will have to pay premium over a period of many years. So while you buy a life insurance policy, say you pay premium in the first year, the recurring premium also has to come back for you to stay insured and for the organization to start making money. The companies, they make money only after 5 or 6 years. Now, if you leave it entirely for the machines to handle, the machine will not be able to connect money. I'll tell you, how many of us have insurance policies? I'm not here to sell that, but just to, you know, draw a perspective. Okay. Now, most of us, what we have done, we have done ECS, you know, which is auto debit in the bank. But that is left, or EMIs that we pay. It is left to the machinery. But the failure rate, okay, of ECS is also very high because you deploy your monetary resources differently for doing different things. Therefore, there is this human connect which is required. Otherwise, the businesses are not going to be sustainable if you don't have. So therefore, you know, the limited point that I'm trying to make is that if you have customer in the center, all your things will revolve around it. You will have some, you know, machinery, but most of it will be done by the human beings, especially when you are meeting customers and in a country like India. So sales and marketing jobs, you know, customer service jobs are not going to be, you know, entirely taken away by machines. Yeah. So that if you pay attention to that, the idea is that you will be able to, you know, find your feet. You will be able to find your careers there. Social media. Now, I think social media is such a subject where you will be able to, you know, tell me a lot of things on, because you guys are more connected. I have certain data, you know, that I wish to share here, you know, on my way. So there are, and this is about US, because most of the data is always about US. So there are 84% budding adults or adolescent people who have Facebook account. 84% of the US population in this, you know, age group. There are 60% of 13 to 17 year old people have a social media account, you know. Internet equals to social media, because 90% plus people use only, you know, they go to internet to use social media. There are about 121 billion, you know, increases, you know, wins over a part of, you know, social media where the mobile phone is being used, you know, over the last few years. And, you know, top three social media platforms. For example, Facebook has got about 2 billion people, 2 billion subscribers to that. YouTube has 1.5 billion. And there is WhatsApp, which has 1.2 billion. You know, these are top three. Yeah. So it's finally about that. It's finally about existing with this. The way we have accepted social media, and I'm not going to be talking about the flip side of social media. I'm only talking about the advantages. It has not only offered you that platform to connect with people. Yeah, it has also, there are so many successful commercial models which are now being operating, you know, on social media. You can talk of the simplest one is restaurants. The simplest one is that you order food online. Yeah. Now this is the magic of social media. What we do, you know, before conferences, we come on a, you know, WhatsApp group in order to make sure that we are all of us are on the same page. Now this is the convenience in the hands, and it has offered so many commercial solutions as well. Yeah. So what you have is your future is created by what you do today and not tomorrow. A little bit of gyan. So what do we do, you know, to stay relevant in the future? Now, IQ is important, and IQ and aptitude is, that's the reason you guys are here. You must have cracked several competitive exams. You know, you must have been pros as mathematics and all the subjects that you've chosen. And you are also developing that side of IQ. What will remain to be, you know, unfolded for future is that the future is about, mostly about EQ. The emotional intelligence or the wisdom that you are developing along with your education, along with your aptitude, is something that will keep you in the job. While aptitude will, you know, get you the job or get you the work or business, but emotional quotient or high emotional understanding or intelligence will keep you in the job forever. Will also not only keep you in the job, but will grow you in that job. Now, there are five elements that you can, you know, there are enough and more books available on this subject, but there are five elements, you know, which are important. One of that is self-awareness. The self-awareness, how aware I am about, you know, me, whether which ecosystem do I operate, whether I am aware of my weaknesses and my strengths. Similarly, self-regulation, when to switch on, when to switch off. How do I use my weaknesses? Where do I stop is important. That is self-regulation. Then you have, you know, motivation, which is also self-motivation. Then you have empathy, and then you have social skills. Now, these are those five important elements of emotional intelligence. Even if you are clear about the definitions of them, if you practice them, automatically the world is going to be, you know, the careers that you will have will be different. So that from future readiness, while you have enough IQ in place and you will continue to acquire more your IQ, what remains to be seen and what is important is that EQ, that emotional connect, that emotional intelligence. Yeah, there is enough material available, so I'm sure you guys are, you know, very well educated and will understand and will go through this. But trust me, future is only about emotional connect, emotional intelligence. Another important part is be imaginative in, you know, in 21st century. Now, enough that I've spoken about the machines. I would like to make a small comment on, you know, this is not my observation, but I've gone through a TED program or a TED, you know, the TED talk, right? It is, you know, the University of Tokyo. Now, this is, they call it Todai, or, you know, and they have an entrance exam around it. Now, what they did, because Japan is an aging country, they need help of robots in the space or the areas of health. Yeah, the senior citizen there needs help, and they have deployed computers. And Frank and Robot, if you see, the gentleman has deployed a computer because of the aloofness or because he's alone there. Now, in Todai, what a small experiment that they conducted, they took a, you know, one of the better softwares or, you know, robots or, you know, artificial intelligence. And there are subjects to crack the competitive exam to enter the university. Now, the areas where the computer could do well was wherever there were patterns. For example, mathematical, yeah, stuff. For example, a current topic was given. So, the computer goes back to the repository and the library that they have, electronic library, and will come back with the best essay, yeah, or best writing. Now, this was possible, but there were some areas clearly where the human beings did better. So, what the lady in the TED talk says that there are 85% is the cutoff marks, you know, for getting admission into, you know, Tokyo University or Todai. this computer managed 60% of the Japanese universities and could crack, but could not crack this because finally it stopped at 80%. Yeah. So what we are saying, the modern times also, the technology that we have today, human beings are irrepressible, both their intelligence also, their EQ is completely irreplaceable at this point of time. The EQ that you will have, you see, you know, 80% and 85% is a huge gap. In 85%, most of the human beings could crack that entrance exam and they, you know, could get an admission there, which is a, you know, reputed institution. But this computer couldn't crack that there, 80%. So therefore, it is important that we develop, okay? We develop the sites or the dimensions that we need to develop, which is mostly EQ along with the IQ. It's about agile. I'm sure I do not need to speak about this because you had a talk in the morning. There was this panel discussion, I understand, on agile workforce. Yeah. So the entire thing here is be smart, be flexible, be responsible, have a goal, have vision, believe in yourself, and develop elements of EQ. You know, one of the most important things that I would like to leave you with. Finally, you know, what I have here is, what is important is keep educating yourself, okay, acquire new skills. There are failures that should be used as learnings, and do not stop from imagination. What remains most important is, along with EQ, is your imagination. Yeah, is about dreaming, is about dreaming with open eyes, is about do not stop, or nothing should stop or terrify you. Yeah, that's very important. So therefore, experimentation becomes very, very important. So in whatever little labs that we have, not the classroom labs, but whatever little interactions that we have with people, try to identify the opportunities, you know, in order to be future ready. Watch a lot of movies. I personally watch a lot of movies, and those are very, very important, and they leave a positive imprint on me. And try to read a few things. I mean, some of the movies that I have said, you guys have already watched. You know, read a book which is called The Rise of the Robot. It's by Martin Ford. Have you read it? Some of us? No? So please read that book, The Rise of Robot. It will talk about, you know, the future. It talks about the skills. Those are going to be, you know, relevant. There is so much of material on social media, but unfortunately, we use social media for something else. Yeah? So that's where. So keep inventing yourself, which is reinventing yourself, which is acquire new skills. And I was talking to one of the students right now in the waiting area. He has completed his schooling, the undergraduate program and the postgraduate program now. So all on track. One will deploy, one will land up a job. And finally, after you will land up a job, you will find that there is a need to acquire new skills. Yeah. Therefore, please keep acquiring new skills. Keep experimenting. Those are going to be a few important, sharings or the perspective that I have for you today. Yeah, the Hindu article that I was referring to. So artificial intelligence is going to create, I said 2.3 million jobs globally by 2020 and not 2022. Now these are going to be different type of jobs. Yeah. What you will also have is, you know, mature economies. Now look at this. People will also start using or believing in false information which is being shared today. Therefore, you will find a scope that whatever we do, now there is so much of data available, there is so much of false information in the modern, the mature economies will start believing in that information which is available, which is not, which is not correct factually. But then those are those areas where we will have to be circumspect, worry about, you know, in order to, whenever we are embracing certain things in certain jobs. Yeah. Then you have, look at this, the skills, how the skills are changing. It says, the same report says, by 2021, IT staff will be more versatile, not only in handling multiple roles, but not in the IT area, but they would have embraced business, you know, they would have a better understanding of business, the IT guys. So therefore, you see, there is a convergence that is happening. Yeah, IT, we have always, you know, known IT guys as geeks, or some business analysts, they would understand business, but not many of them. The world is changing. The world will start to converge and live together. Those are those potential opportunities that we have, we may have. And of course, security. Because of these walls collapsing, because of the global world, the IT security. So those are those areas where plenty of jobs are going to be available, you know, in future. Now this is, I'm not saying it, there is statistics and some organization by the name Gartner, they are into research and advisory. They have made these comments today, you know, through the Hindu newspaper. I think that is what, you know, I had today. Apart from, those little examples which I must have thought and I would have forgotten. But it appears that, you guys are pretty much aware. You are aware and you are doing all the right things, you know, by reaching out to the right material and, reaching out to the right repositories of knowledge. That's important. But it is also important that we stay agile. We are always on toes. We are always thinking. We are always imaginative. It is very, very important. And we are also aware of the ecosystem and what is happening outside the ecosystem. While education is important, IQ is important. But please be aware, your social interactions are going to be making difference to these personalities or the personality that you will acquire over a period of time. So therefore, my submission here to this crowd is, all of you will do well, but the areas will have to be chosen. The jobs are being given by the companies, but the careers will have to be handled by you. First, you will have to be those five elements. You will have to, practice those five elements of emotional intelligence and quotient. And I think things are going to be falling in place. Rest is all. There is enough knowledge in the world. You can acquire it from books, from electronic books, by interactions. But try to focus learning from, interactions. Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you.
My name is Supriya Malhotra. I'm from BIMM. So my question is regarding artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence is all about machine learning. That is what I have understood. And it would be replacing a lot of jobs, but it would also be creating a new set of jobs altogether. But there is another school of thought that says that, for example, a bot can do a job done by 50 people. So it would be replacing the work of 50 people, right? But it would be creating jobs for other set of people who would be managing the machine. But what I think is, the number of jobs created would not be as many as jobs replaced. So what is your take on this?
Okay. Thank you, Supriya. We had, if you remember, I remember it clearly. We had same worries when the computer was introduced. Yeah. As humans, we created unions around, how we should disdain computer, how we should, move computers away from work. But have we not existed? Yeah. The machines will be developed to increase efficiencies. And you are right. There will be initial bloodbath and some loss of job. By 2018 and 19 in the, in the Western world, you will have some jobs which will be, which will cease to exist. But what is going to happen is that there will be 2.3 million jobs. So I am drawing the statistics again, because there is some job loss story as well. But these 2.3 million jobs will also be created, and there are 5 million more than, 0.5 million more jobs than what the job losses will be. Now the idea is that there is going to be an increase in efficiency. You as millennials and the customers will demand more from the same set of machines. Yeah. But what will happen is that you will, as a human being, because you are agile and you have, as human being, we have continued to exist for many centuries, BCE, before common era and after common era. That means we will exist. Okay. There is a doomsday, theory, school of thought, which says Elysium, there will be a huge divide. There is one world there, next to Mars. And then there is one world here, where there is chaotic, complete chaos and anarchy. But that's not going to happen. The same people who have predicted that jobs will be taken away, the same people have also been now, also having predicted that the jobs are not going to be taken away by computers. More jobs will be created by artificial intelligence. Only thing will be, intelligent jobs will be created. You will have to be a little more creative. You will have to bring in a lot of arts and imagination into it. Okay. Painting will be done better and relished and accepted more when it is done by a human being, not by a computer. You will not appreciate that. still Nobel awards will be given to the authors and not to the computers. Yeah, so there will be these kind of jobs, they will exist. It's only that we should embrace machinery or artificial intelligence or machine intelligence to our advantage. Okay, and if we are close to that, then there is a problem. If we are not close to that, if we are accepting, we will exist with machinery and we will exist better than today. I hope I have answered your question. Thank you.
Good evening, sir. Good evening. My name is Neha Bangar. I am from BIMM Marketing. Sir, as in this world of artificial intelligence, you have heard about IBM Watson.
Yes.
So, what IBM Watson is doing, they are acquiring the data in which they are interrupting the personal space of every individual. So, somewhere they are just trying to interrupt in between personal lives. So, what is your take on this?
Okay. You know, thank you. It's a very good question and you appear to be very well informed about this. You know, who is the Jeopardy champion? Jeopardy is a game. Watson is, by the way, the champion there. Okay, and Watson is not a human being. It's not a name to a male. Yeah, it's machine, and you are right. Now, what's happening here is, it is not you are allowing. See, there is so much of hue and cry about the human rights also, so much about privacy. It's only the data. See, data, whether believe it or not, our data is available in the domain today, in the public domain today. You will not be able to protect your data, your identity through data. It's only about data. You exist because there is your data that exists. You know, the reverse has stopped, to be true. Now, what will happen here is, it is not intruding with your work. It is trying to facilitate. But at the same time, please be aware, and you are right. We will have to be worry, little circumspect about what's happening with our data. You should not allow it to, reach your household. While you will have to continue, so it's a double whammy. You will have to continue to look at this. You know, you also want the advantages of this. When I'm saying you means all of us and people outside. It's only that we want to draw advantages of technology and this data. But at the same time, we don't like or we don't appreciate this intrusion. Yeah. But then this will exist. No data will remain private. There will be so much of noise and cry about it. But this will be judiciously used. There are non-disclosure agreements and therefore international laws are also, are evolving now. And you will find that there will be so much of agreements and you will have to write so many contracts with these guys. But the marketeers and artificial intelligence will still run away with your data. For sure. Stay prepared. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your knowledge with us, showing us the future prospects in 21st century. As we should be educate ourselves and dream big to be future ready. Thank you again, sir, for enlightening us with your words of wisdom.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
May I now?